Everyone, a very warm digital welcome to Nyenrode Business University. I'm happy that you're joining us today for an open day regarding the MSc in Management program. My name is Amber Overbos and I work as a program advisor for this program specifically. And today we will be doing two things. Like we said in the email, we will be answering all of your questions. That's why we chose for this session to first have an interview with two members of our program management, our program director Carlijn Wenzel and our senior program manager Lina Haring. We will be introducing them very soon. Of course, we understand that after a full week of online activities, it's quite a challenge to also join an online session on Saturday. So in order to send you a thank you afterwards, please send us your personal home address by email so we can send you something home. So, as I'm a program advisor, usually you as a potential student would be asking all of your questions to me or to my colleagues. But today I will be answering your questions together with the program management, and I will specifically ask your questions to them. After we had the interview with the members of our program management, we will also be having a panel discussion with our current students from the location of Amsterdam as well as Breukelen. Without further ado, let's move on to the first part of this session, the interview with our program management. We received many questions from you by email. Thank you a lot for that. Also, don't forget that we have a chat function where you can also still ask any question you have or questions that pop up through this conversation. Now, let's start with an introduction. Carlijn, could you please introduce yourself?
Thank you, Amber. My name is Carlijn Wenzel and I'm the Program Director of the Master of Science in Management. And next to that, I'm also the director of Nyenrode Amsterdam. I work for Nyenrode now for 7 years in various programs like the accountancy program, the full-time MBA, but also a lot of general management. I'm very happy to meet you today and I hope we can answer all your questions.
Thank you, Carlijn. And Lina, could you also introduce yourself?
Welcome everybody, my name is Lina Haring. I work as a senior program manager at Nyenrode University, specifically for the MSc in Management program. I also work here already for a longer time, almost 10 years. So I'm very familiar with our program, our university, and hopefully we will be answering all your questions today.
All right, so let's start with a bit of a general question. Carlijn, could you tell us what this MSc in Management program prepares you for as a student?
Yeah. Well, it prepares you for working in international business, Amber, and it makes sure that within a year or a year and a half, depends if you're doing the pre-master, yes or no, you find out what kind of a leader you want to become. And based on our values, leadership, entrepreneurship and stewardship, we will make sure that you learn a lot about academics, practical skills, but also personal development.
All right, so if I understand correctly, you will really be prepared as a starter in an international organization.
Yeah, you can work in a corporate environment, of course, but it's more up to you to find out what kind of a leader do I want to become and how, well, what kind of a management style would suit you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right, that's clear. And Lina, so more on a practical basis, how actually does Nyenrode fulfill this? What does the program look like?
And the program starts with the pre-master's program at the end of August, and the pre-master's program is there to really prepare you for the master's program, of course. We need to make sure that all of you have the academic skills, but also the business foundation courses, which you will be acquainted with in the pre-master's, so that you're fully prepared to take off at the master's program. So we will be offering academic skills, statistics, and introduction to business research, but also you will be introduced to subjects like marketing, finance, to give you a good and solid basis in the business studies.
Mm-hmm. So, and in the master phase, what will students actually be doing to become a skills starter?
So after you successfully pass the pre-masters, and that is important that you pass all the courses in the pre-masters program, you will indeed enter the master's phase. And there you first will be following core courses, we call them, as a group together. So you will have courses like management science, supply chain management, but also business finance, introduction to digitalization and strategy. And from there on, you move on to one of our specialization tracks.
All right, so that sounds very broad. And actually one student was wondering, how heavy is the emphasis on financial courses?
Now, it is a business business masters in management. So of course there will be finance courses involved. However, we attract students from different kinds of backgrounds, and that is also very important for us that we have students from all kinds of different bachelor studies to make sure we have a nice diverse group of students. Mm-hmm. Emphasis on finance, yes, there will be a foundation of finance course in the pre-master's phase, there will be a business finance course in the core courses block, and from there on students choose their track. So students who really like finance choose the financial management track and can deepen their knowledge in that. Mm-hmm. And other students will be focusing on other courses and get more in-depth knowledge in those courses.
Yeah, so summarizing also, if finance isn't your favorite subject, this could still be a nice master program for students.
Absolutely, it's a broad master's introducing to in a very broad range of business subjects, and finance is one of them. Mm-hmm.
All right, and so you already mentioned the three tracks. Of course, there are global business, digital business and innovation, and financial management. Could you tell a bit more about those tracks? What do students learn if they enter a certain track?
Now, let's start with the global business track. Maybe the name already says it, but this is all about learning about doing business internationally, and especially in international environment. So it could be decisions, choices about broadening your business to a new country, or taking part of your business to a new country. So really the focus is on international environment and differences in cultures. In the digital track, the focus lays on the digital aspects of doing business, also learning, of course, how do big corporates face and deal the challenges in this digital world that is changing so fast. How do you make a decision in a managing position about a new business branch? What are the aspects from the digitalization perspective that need to be considered? So topics like these will be introduced there.
All right.
And financial management track, coming back to the finance, their students will learn everything about corporate finance, but also about mergers and acquisitions, private equity, asset management, doing all kinds of simulations, visiting companies, listening to guest speakers who talk about those subjects. So you will be prepared as an expert and manager in finance, being able to make decisions from that perspective to offer and raise the value of your company.
All right. And are there any specific requirements for students to choose a track, or?
Now, basically, all students who will be accepted to Nairoda, to the pre-master's program, can do any track they want to. However, if you're really interested in finance, it's already good to focus on the foundation of finance and statistics courses in the pre-masters, as there we do require a minimum grade of a 7. So if you really want to do finance, it's good to already be aware of that and work towards that track. But of course, you might come in as a student thinking you want to do finance and find out that you actually want to do the global track. So that's also possible. Mm-hmm. And the good part is that you only make your choice at the end of your pre-master's program.
Yeah, and our professors always provide additional information sessions for the students before they actually decide on a track. What happens and how does that help in choosing a track?
Every track has a track director also, so that is one of the professors of our university, and they tell more about what is the content of the track, what are the job perspectives after you finish mm-hmm. a certain track. And the very nice part in those specialization introduction sessions is that we also invite our current students who are actually following the track, so that they can tell from their experience and their expectations and also their future perspectives what they are expecting to do after they finalize a track. And that can be very helpful when you choose your track.
All right, thank you, that's very clear. So Carlijn, one of the things that people usually think about when they hear Nyenrode is networks. What does the class profile of the MSc in management look like? It already was mentioned that people with various backgrounds can enter.
Yeah, definitely. Various backgrounds, various experiences. About 30% of our students is international. Mm-hmm. And we feel that it's important to have diversity and inclusivity. Mm-hmm. A part of seeing what kind of an education you've already done, you can enter the program, do the pre-masters and prepare you for the business part of, mm-hmm. of the master. And we feel that it's important that you actually become the person you want to become here. Mm-hmm. So know what you want to, what kind of a person do you want to be mm-hmm. when you actually start working? Mm-hmm. Because we think that authenticity is really important, because if you're in your core authentic you, then you can perform best. Does it answer your question?
It does,
thank you.
I hope for the students as well. So if you have any further questions, for instance, on this topic, please put it in the chat so we can come back to that. People without business background can enter the program, and we say that we accept students with 0 to 2.5 to 3 years of work experience max. Could you give us some examples of non-business backgrounds of people who enter this program?
Yeah, we do have quite a lot of hotel school students, mm-hmm. But also medical students. To be honest, it's a whole variety of different backgrounds, even technical. Mm-hmm. And I think if you're interested in management and you have the right attitude, you have the right mindset, and the right interest, so interest in management and interest in people, in organizations, in cooperating, in making connections, mm-hmm. then the MSc in management is the right studies for you.
All right, great. And Lina, of course, we have the pre-masters that really prepare students to enter the master phase, but we also offer a summer course. Could you tell us what the use of the summer course is to students?
Certainly. So the summer course starts even before the pre-masters, and why do we have it? The reason is, and now I come back again to the diversity of our students, is that we do get students from, like Carlijn already mentioned, from medicine, from engineering, sometimes even from somebody who has done history or music studies. And these are students who are not yet very familiar with mathematics, statistics, academic writing. And the summer course is designed especially for those students to give them a good kickoff before they enter the pre-masters. So what do? They come here on our campus in Preukala and get lessons in mathematics, statistics, introduction to economics, but also in academic writing. So how do you actually read an academic article? For some students, it can be quite new. How do you tackle something like that?
Yeah.
So that is what we introduce in those 2 weeks.
All right. And how do people sign up for this summer course?
They can, during the admission process, they can indicate that they want to take part in that course. Mm-hmm. And students who choose their location Preukala can already move on the campus during those 2 weeks. So that's also a very nice way of already getting to know your fellow students. Mm-hmm. 2 weeks earlier already be welcome on our campus in Preukala.
Yeah, okay, great. And are there any other ways that you would recommend students to prepare for this program already before the summer course, if they want to do a program like this?
Yeah, sometimes during the admission procedure, we notice that somebody is not not very familiar with the business terminology when we talk about marketing or finance or management. So what we often say is, what is handy is start reading business news and start reading magazines like Harvard Business Review, start listening to BBC, also to prepare yourself in English, because of course this program is an English language program, and then it's very useful if you already are acquainted with the terminology that is used in the business world.
All right, and following up on what you're actually already mentioning now, we had a question coming in. To what extent are you supporting English academic writing?
Very good question. Very good question. I hope that I already touched upon it. So the summer course is definitely a good start. So if you now feel that this is something you really need to improve, then I would definitely recommend to join the summer course. And in the pre-master's program, we have a course called Academic Reading and Writing. So definitely also there, a good foundation is laid to be able to write later on your academic papers in the master's phase.
All right. Thank you. So another topic that's always, of course, very important for master's students is career opportunities, Carlijn. Of course, you start this master to really start your career afterwards. And how does it work at Nijrode? How do we prepare students for their career?
Well, when you study at Nijrode, you become part of a community, which is a really big, large community. It's worldwide, it's international. Well, to be honest, you know, when you, for instance, visit America and you're in New York and you just Google or you via the Nijrode network find out which Nijrode alumnus or alumna is actually in New York at the moment, you just give them a call and I'm sure that within half an hour or maybe even the same day, you'll have a short meeting with them. Mm-hmm. Everybody's really prepared to help each other. And of course, we work together with a lot of companies, a lot of businesses. They're incorporated in the program. They're incorporated in network opportunities. We have some nice guest lectures where within the various courses and also some general ones, mm-hmm. where you can meet CEOs or you can meet CIOs or, you know, whatever you're interested in. And find out how they're actually doing in real life. You know, mm-hmm. you can meet them, you can present yourself. And well, I feel that's really a big advantage of Nijrode. Mm-hmm. And it feels like a warm family.
Yeah, all right. Well, of course, we have the network effect. And that's also not too strict, of course. It's also very much up to you as a student. But also in the MSc management program, we have the so-called personal leadership and career development. Lina, could you tell us which elements are in this part of the program?
Yeah, to start off with, at Nijrode we find, and I think that has been said now a couple of times by Carlijn as well, that we find it extremely important that students will have the possibility to develop them also personally and professionally next to the academic curriculum that they are following. And the personal leadership and career development program is an excellent opportunity to do so. That is a program that runs next to the academic curriculum. Students actually will work in smaller working groups. They will have plenty of opportunities to get feedback, but also to learn how to give feedback to your fellow students. And by doing that so, students learn to know what are their qualities, who they are as a person, and they also hopefully find out what kind of jobs fit them the best. Because on one side they work on their personal qualities and personal skills, but on the other side they also do a company project. And what is a company project? It is a project that students do in small groups in a real company. And the nice part there is that we link it to our core values, leadership, stewardship and entrepreneurship. And students choose one of those values in which they want to do their project in. So for example, if students choose entrepreneurship, they actually get to work on their own business idea. So if you're a student, maybe you already have a business now and you think, yeah, it would be really nice to work it out with three or four other students from Nijrode, you could choose the entrepreneurship track or the entrepreneurship stream and work out your business idea. And the nice part is that you are actually coached and guided by our Nairoda coaches, by investors from outside Nairoda and other entrepreneurs who perhaps already have a successful business. So that way you see also that those core values are really integrated in our program, and students can choose to do a project like that.
And could you perhaps give an example of such a leadership assignment that students will do, like a real practical example?
Yeah, if you do a leadership stream in that company project program, I know that last year we had students working for companies like ING, Ahold Delhaize, and those companies actually offer our students an actual problem that they are facing at these times. And especially last year, it was really interesting because we had just entered lockdown, and not only we, but also the companies, of course. And companies were also struggling finding their way how to deal with this new way of working, new way of doing business internationally, across the borders. And these were typical assignments that were given to our students. And they, even in the lockdown period, they got that way exposed to companies. And some of our students actually got the internship opportunities afterwards. So that way we prepare the students for the career. And during their studies, they built a network. And they actually might as well find a job straight after their studies.
All right, so it's not an internship itself. It's really something you do alongside the program. That's also something that our students really like about this track, is that you do your project and for instance, if you have your lectures during daytime and you learn all those academic theories, you can already apply them to reality in your stream within the PLCD. And Carlijn, of course, as the director of Amsterdam, you can also tell us more about our business incubator that really matches, of course, the entrepreneurship value.
Yeah, well, that's practicing what you preach. Being an entrepreneur in Amsterdam, in our garden house, in the garden, we have an incubator where 12 ventures momentarily have their office. And it's a real incubator, which means you can actually develop your business idea. So if you have an idea, you can pitch, you can get a seat in the incubator, you will be guided by a professor of entrepreneurship who will actually help you, give more body to your idea. And, it's 9 out of 10 times our students come in with idea A, and then they start developing it, talking to entrepreneurs, talking to alumni. Of course, within the incubator community, there's a lot of information as well and a lot of guidance amongst each other. And then, to be honest, 9 out of 10 times within a year, they're quite successful, but in a different idea. Because the first idea was really, really nice, but of course you have to get to your core value on what you want to be an entrepreneur in, and that's something that's really incubated, so formed within our incubator. And we have some nice examples like Farm Brothers, probably you know them from the supermarket, the real nice biological cookies. And what we also find really important in our incubator is that there's a sort of there's an element of social responsible leadership within doing business, because we feel that doing business should also enhance being social responsible. So not only about making money, making money is of course a core element of doing business, but it would be nice to give something back to the society as well. Like for instance, Far Brothers, they make sure that with every package of cookie they sell, one square meter of soil is made healthy again.
Okay.
So I think that's also part of being a social responsible leader. So the incubator is actually about practicing what we preach.
All right, that sounds good. And so Lina, this value, of course, that we have in the incubator with our entrepreneurs, how do we bring it across during the MSc in Management program? So being really a responsible leader.
It's being a responsible leader, I think, starts also as an individual student, taking responsibility for your own actions, especially in the Nairobi community that is so close. It is very important that you are really taking responsibility for your own actions, because it can have a huge impact on the community that has been there already since 1946, of course. So that is something that we hope to teach in that personal leadership and career development program again, because like I said, students get a lot of feedback from their peers, but also from the coaches and staff members of Nairobi. And by receiving that feedback, there will be so many reflection moments on your own behavior that it is really possible to grow into a more responsible leader.
Mm-hmm. All right, and so we just got another question in. What proportion of the course is marketing focused? So I feel that people are a little bit looking at, like, where is the focus in this program, or is that something that's really up to the student itself?
Do you mean the marketing course or the
content? So what proportion of the course is marketing focused? Yeah.
Okay. In the pre-master's program, we do have a marketing strategy course taught by one of a very respected professor at Nairobi, Professor Robin. Next to that, in the digital track, I believe students might be finding the most courses which are related to marketing, because it will be also about customer behavior and customer journey, retail. So I think if students are looking for learning more about marketing, then the digital track would be more suitable for them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and all right. So when it comes to finding a focus, I kind of hear you saying that students can go also into various directions, right, with this program?
Definitely. So if it's about focus, indeed, then we should talk about again our three tracks we have available. So the digital track, yes, it is about digitalization and how do companies deal with it, but it is definitely also about certain marketing subjects that come back there. Finding focus, if you are focused on doing business in an international environment, then the global track is there for you. And if you want to deepen your knowledge in financial management, then the financial management track is there for you.
All right. And Carlijn, we had a question coming in, which is always an interesting one. Why Nairobi and not some other university?
Yeah, well, to be honest, it's your personal choice. But I would say that Nairobi offers you, next to the academic knowledge, of course, where you get a lot of knowledge and a lot of interesting subjects that are taught, I would say that the extra plus would be, do you have a moment? Because I have quite a lot of lot of those. But I would say it would be practical skills. So you actually, you know, learn how to use this academic knowledge in practice. So you can actually kickstart your career by actually doing, because you didn't only learn it, but you also know how to apply it. I think a very valuable part is that you actually do know yourself really, really well. So you know what you're good at, you know what you're maybe not so good at, because you can't be good at everything. And that makes you a more complete or stable employee. Mm-hmm. And within everything you do, especially when you start working in a management position, you work with others. So it's very important to know yourself so you can act and react in the right way towards others and help others develop themselves as well. Because we feel you can only develop in interaction with somebody else. Mm-hmm. So it's all about connecting. And I think that's the extra thing Nairobi definitely gives you. Apart, of course, from the network, which is worldwide, and the sense of community.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so with that, would you say that there is a typical Nairobi student, or as a program director, what are you looking for in students when you accept them?
Well, we're looking for people who are really interested to develop, interested to learn, who really want to work hard, but also play hard. And mm-hmm. of course, the working part is done in the academic and in the practical skills part, but especially the play hard is done at campus, living at campus, being part of a community, maybe even being part of the students' associations we have. And I think the combination is what makes the total picture.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. Yeah, so it's nice to hear, I think, also for the student that there is not like one typical profile that you have to comply to.
Yeah, definitely not. We feel that diversity, inclusivity, various people from different backgrounds, experiences is really contributing to developing to the utmost. But you have to be willing, you have to be interested, you have to have the right mindset and the right attitude.
All right. Yeah. Thank you. So, following up on that, so we do have two locations, and of course we will also discuss that with the students that actually chose the locations. But how do students choose a location?
Well, the first thing is of course to get information about the location, which we're giving today. In Breukelen you live on the rural estate. Campus is actually situated on the estate. And there you're, amongst others, 24/7. Mm-hmm. And you're part of the Nijenrode, or the NCV, the Student Association. So this is, I think, interaction to the utmost. And there you can develop yourself in, learning how to interact with others, how to solve problems, mm-hmm. how to give each other feedback. And I think, if you want to live in a very close community, Breukelen would be a very good choice. On the other hand, we also have our very nice campus in Amsterdam, where we say the whole city, so the metropole of Amsterdam is our campus. Mm-hmm. And their students actually do not live on our premises, but we do have a campus in Diemen Zuid, where you can choose to rent an apartment if you want to, or you can choose to live in the city. Mm-hmm. And it's very good to know that the academic student life is the same at both locations. The student experience, so more the social part, is of course different.
Yeah.
Being in a campus on the estate or being in a larger international city.
Yeah, so that also of course makes that the choice of location is just very personal. And will you also be discussing this with students?
Definitely, of course, on one hand is giving information, on the other hand is helping the student, or helping you, make the right choice. And that's something we will do within our admissions interviews and the different conversations we have with you. And there, the most important part is your preference. What suits you best?
Yeah. All right, great. Lina, when students apply for this program, they will have to take a few steps in admissions, and one of them is the Nijenrode LTP test. What is this test about?
Yeah, we have developed that LTP test for students who want to join the program. And what is it about? It has two parts. One part is about the intellectual capabilities, which is very important for us because that is a good indicator for us to see whether a student is and will be successful in our program. Important for us, but more important even for you. And the second part of the test is the personality test. Mm-hmm. So there we get an indication of what kind of a profile do we have in front of you. And of course it is a computer generated test, so for us even more important than the test is the individual interview, what we have with every student who takes the test and gets the score that is required. So during that interview we talk about further about your motivation to do your studies. To do your studies at Nijenrode, we discuss the preferred location, we talk about your ideas and views on the management, and that way we actually make sure that yeah, that you fit here and that is the right program. And not only we, during that conversation, also students will have the possibility to ask their final questions, mm-hmm. which they still might have, because it needs to be a fit. We really would like that you feel that this is the right program for you and that you feel that Nairoda will offer what you are looking for to make that next step in your career and in your studies.
Mm-hmm. Great. And can do students also receive some information to prepare for the test and the interview?
Yeah, certainly. So after you have submitted your application form, you will become in contact with our admissions officer and she will guide you through the next steps, and one of the steps is that she will send you some preparation materials for the test, the LTP test.
All right, great. And about the scholarships, are there any scholarships available for students?
Yes, we have also scholarships available, and I think this is a beautiful example of how strong our alumni network is, because many of the scholarships are offered by our alumni who are often at the end of their career and they really want to do something back for Nairoda and they really want to invest in talent. So there is a Nairoda fund available, and our alumni actually invests in that fund, and from that fund we offer a certain number of scholarships for you, and there are also some scholarships that we offer from Nairoda, from our program itself. Does that answer?
Yeah.
Should I?
Yeah. And it's good to know that indeed we have limited amount of scholarships, so we really look into your special motivations, and you also need to submit a financial plan to make sure that we actually give the scholarships to those who really need this financial aid. And then actually the final question for this interview. Okay, almost final question. Do you accept a maximum of people in the program, Carlijn?
Yes, we do. And that has to do, of course, because we want to give you the personal attention you're entitled to. Mm-hmm. And that means we want to have small classes. We want you to give, the information, the right groups, etc. So that's why we say we do have a maximum amount of students we do accept.
All right, yeah. Great. So Lina, as a program manager, is there any last thing you would like to give the people at home as advice?
First of all, I want to really thank you for taking the time to be here with us today. Last advice, look around also in other universities to make sure that you have seen two or three different studies that are available, because that also helps you to make the right choice that fits you the best. And if you think that Nairoda is the right choice to you, for you, then hopefully we can welcome you here even before you start your studies for a campus tour. And otherwise, we will meet you in the program.
All right, how about you, Carlijn? Any last remarks?
Yeah, I totally agree with Lina, of course. Mm-hmm. It's about making the right choice at the right moment. And as academics, of course, we always want you to investigate. So please do that. And where we can help you, of course, we will do so. And the moment it's possible again, we would love to welcome you to our estate. I hope in the digital way today we gave you a good impression. And what I would say, stick to your own values, and really, you know, it's not about mindset only, or about your mind, it's also about what's your, like we say in Dutch, onderbuikgevoel.
Your gut.
Your gut feeling. That's really important.
All yeah. Right.
So we hope to see you soon.
Thank you so much, both. Of course, you will be meeting a lot of these students who are watching today, I'm sure. Before we move on to our student panel, we will be showing you two videos. And the videos will be about our location in Amsterdam and in Breukelen. And we will now first start with a video about Breukelen.
My name is Bernard Ferreira from South Africa. I'm 25 years old, MSc 29. I just want to show you guys the Nairoda Castle here in Breukelen, which is obviously part of the big image of Nairoda, and it's super, super cool for international students and everyone around. But there's not all Nairoda campus has to offer, so come with me and let me show you campus life. As you can see now, we're here by the Kutsays, which is part of the NCV, which is a newer company from FADA, which is the Student Association of Nairoda. So at the bottom, we have many student events like Jazz Night, Transfer Dinner, etc., and all of the rest, which you'll still learn about. And on the first floor, we've got our Zolder Bar, which is one of two bars that we have on campus. And I'm currently now in the Middenpad, which you will find yourself walking along, not only for academic, but also for social side. And right next to the Kutsays, we also have one of our two study centers on campus. So now we're here by the small nature reserve on Nairoda campus, which is super, super cool. For students who just feel like getting a break during their studies or going for a walk during the day, especially for international students, you don't really see this often, and we're really privileged to have this. And yeah, it's a nice getaway just for the day. Now we're on the Nairoda Estate Store, where we are walking next to the nature reserve, where we have hatches and a few nandus, which is super cool for the international students. Next to that, we also got a rugby field, indoor sports hall, and a gym, which is super, super cool. Next to that, we've got our Mensa, which is the lunch and dinner facilities, where we have the NCV hosts the main table events, which is dinner and debates, which is really nice for students to get together in the evenings. And that is held on Mondays. And so after that, let me take you to the library and the Albert Heijn building. So we're on the Middenpad now. And to the right, you can see the Plessman Hotel, which is one of two hotels on campus, where if you're an international, your parents are more than welcome to come stay here. And we have many externals and executive MBA programs that take place during the week, and most people make use of these facilities. We are currently at the Albert Heijn building, where you can mostly find reception, and most of your lectures will take place here, as well as program management can be found here, and your lecturers in case you need to contact them. And directly across the Albert Heijn building, you get the library, where mostly after lectures you will come discuss things with your group, where you can find silent rooms to do your own study, or cubicles to also do your own study if you really want to focus for exams. Now we're at the beginning of the Middenpad, so whatever lies behind me is what I just told you, from the library, the Mensa, to the castle, to the nature reserve, and beyond this is where our daily lives take place, where the student lives, and where we all interact with one another. And let me show you around. We've come to the end of our Nairoda campus tour that I gave you. Sorry that I couldn't give you the full campus tour, but hopefully when Corona's done and you guys have the opportunity to come to campus, you'll have a full experience of what it's really about, and I guarantee it'll not disappoint you. So thank you for watching, and yeah, good luck.
Well, I hope that gave you an impression of kind of what to expect of our campus in Breukelen. Now let's switch to Amsterdam.
So I have multiple reasons for choosing for Nairoda Amsterdam. First of all, I just love that it is in the center of the city. It's so easy to go.
I chose to study at Nairoda instead of other universities because I was really impressed by the atmosphere that Nairoda had. I feel that Nairoda empowers me and makes me feel trusted to make certain decisions.
There are so many startups, interesting businesses, and they are all just around the corner. So I think that makes the campus location in Amsterdam super special.
Specifically to the campus, I really enjoy the Biz Lounge because it's the main part where you have all the functions, so you make a lot of memories there.
I just really like the way that Nairoda treats its students. And then another thing that makes Nairoda really special is that it is so much based on the reality of the businesses. You don't just have to study from a book, it's really practical. So you have guest lectures from people who really have important functions in businesses.
Lecturers really try to engage students, and there's a lot of back and forth in lectures, very interactive, which really helps with the learning process. In Nairoda Amsterdam, we have the incubator. Who want to start up a company can approach for aid and get an office space in the Amsterdam building. The ACV is our student association in Amsterdam, and we organize all sorts of events, ranging from formal business events to parties. Being on the board of the ACV, I've learned a lot of management skills that I otherwise would not have learned.
Yeah, I think the main focus of Nairode is really to be better as a person. That also includes in the core sports. And I think it really teaches you to be proactive and to work on yourself.
So the atmosphere in Nairode is one that is very open, and it's safe to make mistakes. You are able to learn from your experiences and move forward from there.
So, now that we saw the videos of our students from Breukelen and from Amsterdam, I'm pretty sure you have some questions to those students who are actually part of that community already. So, I'm happy that during this session we have three of our current students joining us. We have Isabella van der Graaf from our location of Amsterdam, Helene Otte and Sebas van Dongen from Breukelen. So please go all out in the chat with all of your questions so my colleagues can write them down and give them to me. And let's first start with a short introduction by all three of you. Helene, could you please start by telling us who you are, what you've done in the past, and what you do, for instance, in the Student Association?
Definitely. Thank you, Amber, for having us, first of all. So my name is Helene Otten. I am 22 years old and I am a master's student of Nairode at Breukelen. And before my master's studies, I did international hospitality management in Apeldoorn. And after I finished my bachelor degree, I felt like I was not academically challenged to my maximum yet. So I was interested in doing a master's degree. And what really attracted me at Nairode is the combination of the academic part, but really focused on business. So in all courses, it's really noticeable that all teachers and just the program is really focused on the business life. So that's what really attracted me at Nairode. So yeah, that's basically really short who I am. Oh, also about committees. Yes, I'm also part of the student association that we have at Breukelen. And I am in two committees there. I'm in Collegie tot het Protocol. That's a committee that is busy with helping with open days. Also the business game that Nairode organizes. And also the uni buddies. So if you later on want to chat with me, you can also chat with me via the Nairode website, and you can find me there at Unibuddy. And I'm also in another committee, which is Dionysos. This is more a fun committee. It's also called the Wijndispuut. And Dionysos organizes monthly events for all of its members. And they are all about, yeah, wine and food and examples of events that we organize is Bubbles and Oysters, or the Gin Tonic Boat in Amsterdam once a year. So those are just examples. So we organize monthly events. So that's more of a fun committee that I'm part of. So yeah, right. That's really who I am and what I do at Nairode.
Great, thank you. And let's move to Isabella. Could you introduce yourself?
Yes, of course. Hello, my name is Isabella. I'm 26 and I'm currently a master's student in Amsterdam. Before Nairode, I was at Team Academy. It's a BBA in entrepreneurship, and where I had the opportunity to start my own company as well. So I had my own jewelry company. That's why I think I chose as well a bit for Amsterdam, because one, the entrepreneurship is a bit more the core value as well there. As well, I think the same as Elaine, I still missed a bit of the academic challenge. So for me, I really saw that I could find this in Nairode. And also, I lived already in Amsterdam. For me, the decision was quickly made. But of course, I'm still part of the student association as well here in Amsterdam. I'm currently the president of the board. So yeah, I help a bit in all the committees. I think it's nice to know that we really try to make the best of it now, because of with COVID, everything is online. So really try to make an A plan and a B plan. So I think when you guys join here, we have a really nice plan set. So we really can, take the fruits out of the plant here, I guess.
So great. That's it. Thank you. And last but not least, Sebas.
Yeah, hi there. I'm Sebas van Dongen. I'm 23 years old. I studied law in Utrecht before coming to Breukelen. I've also done a gap year, did some traveling in South America for half a year, learning Spanish, etc. And then I came to Breukelen. I wanted to do a business or management master next to my bachelor in law. And I've been in St. Gallen in Switzerland to go there and visit the business university. And I could go there as well, but I didn't. Eventually, I chose for Breukelen because the student life really attracted me. And until now, it didn't disappoint me at all, even though we had the COVID-19 outbreak in the Netherlands as well. But well, I really enjoyed my time here. As of committees, I'm the vice chairman of the Heren Vijf. It's the board of the new company van Verre. It's our student association. And just like what Isabella just told you guys, we are really planning to go in full with all the events, etc. in the second half year. Hopefully the corona measures, well, we'll have place for that. But I'm confident that we will give you a great time here.
All right. Well, you already mentioned the student associations on both locations. And I was wondering, do you also cooperate with the two organizations? And if so, how? Perhaps you could say something about that, Isabella.
Thank you for asking. Of course, we are currently talking with both boards. And I think it's really our goal this year about connecting, really finding a way to do a lot of things as possible. And I think in Breukelen, there's a lot of possibilities, of course, also regarding sports now and other things. So I think it's a really nice opportunity to make a way that both student associations work together. So I don't even think if you choose for Breukelen or you think you choose for Amsterdam, you have opportunities to get a bit of both. So I think it's really nice. And that's a bit of a goal as well this year.
All right, great. And Helene, could you perhaps tell us about the different events or things you did to make a decision on this studies program?
When I was in your shoes last year, when I had to make a decision for where I wanted to do a master, I visited a lot of open days. Of course, the first part is deciding on what program you want to follow, what master degree you are interested in. And so when I knew sort of my direction, I started visiting open days. And then I also participated in the Nairo the Business Game weekend. I know, fortunately, this January couldn't take place because of the corona, of course. But that's when I really realized, okay, Breukelen campus life, it's quite intense. Of course, it's how intense you make it yourself. But I experienced it as a really... a live atmosphere, really everyone knew each other. The vibe was very professional and I felt like many students were very ambitious, but also really relaxed and fun. So this combination was attracted me so much about Nijrode. And I also really enjoyed the case that I worked on. So when I got to know Nijrode a bit better by doing these types of things and talking to students, I really felt like, okay, this is, I think, where I can get the most out of a 1.5 year master time. So that's when I decided to go for it. And of course, also after quite some conversation with you, Amber, and with other members of Nijrode to really get to know the program well, because I think it's quite an important decision. So it's really important that you also, really... research what the best option is for you.
Good, great. And Sebas, during the first part of this session, we spoke to the program management and they, amongst many other things, told us that this program is quite practical. You've done an academic bachelor in law. How do you experience that level of practice in this program?
Well, doing law in Utrecht, you're in a, as a first year, I was in a group with 1,000 other students, I think. It was huge. We had our lectures, etc., sometimes in the Jaarbeurs, which is a big event hall. And then coming here, that's like a big difference. I mean, we have, the practicality here is, especially with the smaller groups that you have here, like you have lessons in groups of, well, I think our master group now consists of 80 students that live very close together on campus. So you get to know your fellow students very good. And you have very close contacts to all teachers, and that is something that is totally different than what I experienced in Utrecht, where I had these big lectures, etc. So when you talk about contact one-on-one with professors, etc., most professors even share their private cell phone numbers, etc. When you have questions, you can always call them, and that's unbelievable. So that's very different than I experienced before.
All right, great. And also something that students are wondering about, if they don't have a specific background, is it doable to take the pre-masters?
It's a question for me,
Homer? Sorry, yeah, to you. Suppose.
Yeah, it is. I did a year of economics in my bachelor next to law. But to be honest, it didn't really help me doing my pre-master. Of course, it's a bit helpful, but the pre-master is doable. Just take your time, especially if you don't have any experience with the subjects that are in the pre-master, please do take the time. But then I think we had only a few dropouts this year. So yeah, it is very doable. And almost everyone that's coming here you don't just need a business background, let's say, put it like that. Most people have very different backgrounds. People come from technical universities, hotel management, etc. So it's doable, yeah.
All right, great. And we actually already have some questions coming in through the chat, so that's great. Thank you all at home. One question is, did you change your mind during the pre-master and chose a different track than you initially thought? Isabella, could you answer that one?
For me, I think I was a bit doubting when I started. I think Sebastian really explained everyone can start from every background. So I did a bachelor in business, but it was very entrepreneurship, very practical. So I think a lot of courses were really new for me. So I was really struggling in the beginning, but I think Robert of the Program Management of Amsterdam, the master, he really said it nicely, it's just a little learning curve. And then, I don't know, if you get through it, then it's really nice and you're getting ahead. And then I think I really found my passion for finance. And I really started liking it, and I saw how you could like really apply it. So I was really open-minded when I started. And yeah, I chose to do the finance track. So I don't think you really need a clear decision. I think it's also nice if you're open-minded and you're still looking what you like. The pre-master gives a lot of opportunities for that. So for me, that was really helpful. So I'm looking forward to start the finance track.
Great. And Helene, which track did you choose?
I'm going to do the digital business and innovation track. I have to say that when I started my pre-master, I did not really know yet what I wanted to do, and I didn't really do a lot of research at that moment. But of course, during your pre-master, you have to think about what you want to do. Finance is not really my thing. I don't have a big love for finance. Of course, it's very important to have some financial skills and abilities, and that's also what's good about this program, because you do have to learn the basics and really to develop to a certain level. But then for specialization, I knew finance was not my thing. So and then I started reading and talking more to students from the year above us about global and the digital track. So and digital is really new for me. So I just saw a big opportunity for myself to specialize and develop my in this area. And I think what also attracted me is the possibilities for in the future to have this kind of specialization. So that's what interested me very much about the digital track. So yeah.
All right. And Sebas, do you happen to have chosen the global track? So did we have all three
no,
in the room?
No, I didn't. No.
You did?
No, I'm sorry. I also did the finance. No, I did. I chose the finance track as well.
All right. All right.
Just out of interest, and I like the finance subject that we had in pre-master. But to be honest, I didn't know as well before I went to Nairobi. Just at the end of the pre-master, I chose the track that most suited me. So.
All right. Great. We had a second question. How important are the English language skills for this program? perhaps you could answer that question, Isabella.
Yeah, I can quickly give an answer on that. It's quite important. I luckily did a bachelor in English before as well, so it helped. But still, I think it's academic English. So you have to in the pre-master, you get the course. So I think that's really nice. But if you're already thinking about starting in September, just start watching more already English movies, read about it, start reading academic papers if you want to. But I think it's good to already start reading up, then the pre-master would be a bit easier, but there's a really good teacher who's going to help you a lot. But yeah, it's quite important because, yeah, everything is in English. So I hope it gave an answer to that.
You did, yes, thank you. Well, we have a question. Would you advise to live on campus? And this is, of course, an interesting question because the people from Breukelen will start nodding. And of course, Isabella really chose differently. But perhaps we can kind of rephrase this question ask you, Helene, what you think are the benefits of living on campus?
So I think the benefits of living on campus is, of course, the close contact with your fellow students. Of course, when you start your master's degree, you've already done a bachelor, you have your friends, you have your hockey team or whatsoever. But when you go to Breukelen, of course, you can maintain the old relationship, but everyone is really open for new friendship, new contacts. So I think that's just a great way of doing your master's by such close contact with your fellow students. Also, for me, I personally experienced, well, as I mentioned earlier, finance is a difficult course for me. And you're so close to all other students. So there's many people that are really good in finance. So you help each other out. It's a really nice atmosphere. And also, of course, the social side. So having dinner together, and of course, normally when the bars were still open in the summer, going to the bar. So it's really the social interaction that is the greatest benefit of all. Yeah. All
right. And Sebas, do you have anything to add to that?
No, I totally agree with Elaine. This is funny, like we had Corona, of course, in the summer when we came here. Well, we were welcomed in such a way that it let you forget about the outside world, to be honest. It's kind of a bubble inside. And I think that's just something that's coming with a campus. But Elaine just told you, indeed, there are second years that are very good at finance, or even of your own year as well. But those are the second years. They just come to you and say, oh, do you need any help? And then they come and sit with you to get you through the subject. I think in that way, well, everyone has a big and huge chance to get it for the pre-master and the master itself. And of course, we have the association, the NCV, which is very, very active on campus. We have almost 50 committees. I think most of the people that we have living on campus, they join a committee or two or three or four and are very active. And that makes it a very special place to study.
Yeah, I think to add on that, also during my bachelor, I was not part of a student association. So an active association like the NCV also gave me the opportunities, for example, to go with a dispute. I don't know if the Dutch students will probably know about this. So like if you have not been a member during your bachelor's, it has like great opportunities for your master's phase. I think also at the JCV this is the case, but that's also really unique about Nairobi, that you are becoming part of such a active association. I think that's nowhere else in the Netherlands where for a short amount of time, like 1.5 years, you are so active within the association, or at least have the opportunity to be.
All right. And of course, we can also counter this question. Isabella, what is the benefit of choosing Amsterdam for your studies at Nyenrode?
I think the benefit is, of course, it's really nice on the campus. But I do think everyone, of course, you can live in your own place in Amsterdam. And I think a lot of people who go for Amsterdam, like that a bit more. But I do think there's a lot of connections still. Like we're with the JCV, we have not 50 committees, but we have now coming a new one, a 10th. But it's really nice though, because the people who want to be active and want to participate, they are there. And we're really eager to start planning things, doing things together. So I think in Amsterdam, you get a bit more the opportunity how much you want to be part of it or not. But I do think starting Nairobi, Berkeley or Amsterdam, you're of course part of a community. So I do think it's really nice in Amsterdam that you have a bit more the space to choose so. But I do think if you really want this experience, you can get it. Like going into these committees, working together, and really get a lot of out of it. So I do think, yeah, you still will get the full experience of the student association.
Yeah, great. So you also talk to your fellow classmates a lot.
Yeah, it's of course differently. We're not on campus together, mm-hmm. but you can still do Corona. Of course, you can go for a walk with new people you meet. You have online calls, but you still notice as well, we do like online things. We do a pop quiz. And of course, it doesn't sound very exciting, but because we're trying, a lot of people are like, okay, let's do something new, what we're going to do. And now the rules around sports are getting a bit looser. So everyone is like, okay, maybe a tournament. So yeah, I think in that way with the creativeness, you really will get connected. And I do think when we have a really nice gala committee though, so they're looking when it's possible. And so we will have nice events. So you won't miss out anything.
Great to hear. Great. Another question that we had was how many students are in one class normally? Well, of course, currently we have online classes only, so that's a bit different to answer in these circumstances. But perhaps, Sebas, could you say something about how that was when we did the blended learning format?
Yeah, well, to be honest, we did have live classes in the beginning of our year. So for the first 3 months, I think we did have live classes. To be honest, I like them more, but I think that goes for everyone, of course. But then, yeah, then you are just in a group with, you have a big group that you have your lectures with. So that's like with all the master students, but there are not so many. I mean, there is only 70 or 80 of you. So we have them in a big lecture hall, and to be honest, the teachers, they are very active in getting everyone to join the lecture. So you're there and you have to put on your name board in front of you. So there's no way of escaping the questions of the teacher. So he makes sure that you're active no matter what time it is. So that helps, and that's what they're actually doing in the live lectures as well. So they have your names and they just say, oh, Helene, please answer that question. Or what do you think about it? And that really helps. And in addition to that, we also have many group projects in small groups or five or six people doing different group projects. And the teacher comes in and talks to your group as well. So that's still going on, and they are actually doing quite a good job. But of course, I'm looking forward to having live lessons again very much, but we'll just have to wait for that, I think.
Yeah, you're totally right. And that is, of course, also what Nairode strives for, to introduce offline classes as soon as possible again. So, but thanks for explaining this. What advice would you give to a potential student, something that you would have liked to know before you entered Nairode? Helene, could you answer this?
I would just say go for it. If I talked to myself like 1 year ago, I was a little bit in doubt. I thought, is it going to be too intense? I don't know. It's such, for until this point, it just has been such an amazing experience. And I've already made so many new friends that I know are for life, and also the academic part. I'm also close to some students that are 1 year above me, and they are now job seeking and in this process. And I talk to them, and I know it's going to be really helpful for me when I'm in their shoes next year. So I think that's something that I would say to myself. Yeah.
And how about you, Isabella? What would you have liked to know before you went?
I think, yeah, of course, for you guys, you can't really go to the campus now and think. But I think what for me was really nice to talk to the students. So now you're talking with us, but maybe reach out and just try to talk to as many people, because I think when I just started doing that a bit later, that was really the point, that was like the turning point. I was like, okay, I think what Elaine says, just like, it's such a great experience, even though it's now a challenging time. I do think a school like Nairobi really tries to get the best out of it. And if you go to a bigger university, you will be quicker, like one of a thousand. And that's of course not a problem, but I do think with Nairobi, they really will try to get the best experience for you and the people around you. And I do think that's a really big bonus. And yeah, you get to meet so many people, and I wouldn't really miss it. So, yeah.
All right. Great.
Right by.
And Sebas?
Yeah, just go for it. This is, I think, the right thing to say. I mean, this experience that we had is not for sale anywhere in the Netherlands, and I think nowhere in Europe as well. So, that's just very unique about Nijrode, not only in Netherlands, but also in Europe. So if you're in doubt of going to Erasmus, which is also a very good management school, but in Nijrode, you get the extra experience, and that's worth every penny, I think. So yeah, just do it.
All right. So we have one more question, actually. So also final call to the people who are watching. If you have questions, please put them in the chat so we can answer them. The question we got is, do you go abroad during the master? Could you perhaps answer that question, Sebas?
Yes, you do, actually. I think this year it will be in after summer for us, but they are already very busy organizing it. Normally we have, with every track you go to a different place. The global and digital tracks go to China, and the finest track goes to New York. The people from last year didn't go due to Corona. That's a pity for them, but they had an other program in Breukelen, which is also very interesting, I heard. But of course we hope to go, if you speak to the people before last year, then they were are very enthusiastic about this this week. And it's funny, we have in this in Breuk, but I think in Amsterdam as well, you have a committee that organizes the whole event around what the university organizes. So it's not only the serious week that you have there, but it's also they are also planning events around it. And sometimes people even go for two or 2.5 weeks if the study program allows it, and also go to a nice hotel or to an island together. So, I heard that's a great experience, but we didn't go yet.
All right. So about that, Isabella, do you actually have any holidays in between this program? Because, of course, it's 16 months on one end.
To be honest, it will be hard working, but I do think there are opportunities, of course, that you can go for long weekends so you have like blocks, and then every time after the exams, school mostly will have like a couple of days of less classes. Mm-hmm. So then you have opportunity to go abroad. But I do think if you start this experience, then you will probably be a lot busy with school, so you really need to look when you have a holiday. So you don't have like a big summer holiday anymore of 6 weeks, so really enjoy this upcoming time. You have time off enough, but not big holidays anymore.
All right, great. I'm checking with my colleagues if no further questions came in. So I'd like to thank you, you three, for answering those questions that the students have. I think this really gives some idea, a sense of, also who you are, of course, because you are actual Nijrode students. And, I look forward to seeing you guys again in real life as well. Like Helene also mentioned, she can also be found on the Unibody app on our website. And I'm pretty sure that you can also find Isabella and Sebas through LinkedIn if you have any further questions for them that you don't wish to ask here on YouTube Live. So that's completely fine. The students will now leave this session before I close it. So thank you all so much. Have a lovely weekend ahead, and see you soon. Yeah, so that was our online session. I hope it gave you a good impression of what you can expect both from the program and the experience side when you choose for the MSc in Management program at Nyenrode. Like I said at the beginning, don't forget, if you are here and you hear this, please email us your home address, because we have a very nice thank you present to reward you for investing your time in this online session. Myself and my colleague Gina van Hiel are of course also available at any time to answer your questions regarding this program. We look forward to being able to welcome you here on this location of Breukelen of Amsterdam again in the near future. And I wish you a very nice day ahead, and we talk soon.